Welcome to another episode of the Brandywine Angler. Today is Saturday, September 22nd, 2018. We've got overcast skies and a cold front coming through later in the day. And we're going to be headed to the Barnegat Light to see what we can do in some salt water. We'll catch you when we're there. Here we are, Barnegat Light, Barnegat Inlet. We're gonna try to catch some fluke to start, summer flounder. And if no luck with that, we've got some stuff for gear for tog, so we'll try that. Also heard there's some blues around. Here's our setup for today. We've got a couple of 4-inch Berkeley swimming mullets. We got a little double dropper. Two dropper loops cut in the single lines. It's a bit like a drop shot setup with a 1-ounce sinker. We'll see if 1 ounce is enough to hold bottom. Okay, here we go. First cast. See if I can get that on the bottom. The tide's really running pretty hard. I might need more weight. Oh, Jesus. I almost lost my bucket. Gotta go down in between the rocks and get it. A gust of wind came up and blew it off. Now I gotta go down there and get it. I'm kinda lucky it landed the direction it landed, which is ass side up. Or I should say right side up. Still nowhere near the bottom. All right, I need more weight. We're gonna try 2 ounces. See if that does the trick. Alright, let's see if that get on the bottom or not. Oh yeah, that's on the bottom. Oh, that felt like a hit. No. That's hunch. It looks like there are a lot of birds working over there. Maybe I will head up there, take a bluefish plug or something and cast it around up there, because those are definitely birds working. Almost certainly snapper blues. Give it a try. Batch of fish working. Oh, there's another batch of fish working. what they're gonna hit, if anything, but they're fishing here. I can see them feeding. Try something else. This is not catching anything. Switch out and go with plan something else. I don't know if it's B or what, but plan something. I think my next move, it's hard to imagine if they're not hitting the Hopkins what they're gonna hit. Because the Hopkins is usually pretty darn good, but could try a little pencil popper and see what that does. That guy was fishing pencil popper and didn't catch anything. But he wasn't fishing this pencil popper. He was fishing a way bigger one. And I don't think these are all that big a fish. Alright, so this is a tiny, like half ounce or three quarter ounce. And now it's maybe it's a 1 ounce. I don't remember. Stan Gibbs pencil popper that's probably 30 years old. There's one. Little tiny bluefish.
Didn't film an outro on the water because A, I was completely soaked after taking a few waves in the full frontal. B, at that point I was pretty convinced I wasn't even gonna make a video from the footage because catching three dink snapper blues is not really conducive to a good video. And C, I was worried about the sound quality because by the end, the wind was ripping so much, I figured you wouldn't be able to hear anything. But in the end, I decided to go ahead and take a look at the footage to see what it looked like. And I decided to make a video, and I hope you don't mind that the video doesn't show a ton of fish being caught, because I wanted to give folks some sense of one part of the experience of fishing the jetties there at Barnegat Light. I did, you know, have three different approaches to fishing that day. The fluke bite was definitely not happening. I didn't see any boat out that was drifting the mouth of the inlet with a fish on or land a fish. I think they're all fluke fishing. Of the three of us who were out on the point of the jetty trying to catch those bluefish, the other two guys, they were fishing with surf spinning rods and reels and surf tackle, and those bluefish were little bluefish. So I don't think they caught any bluefish. I did see one guy catch a needlefish, snag hooked it by the tail, but that doesn't really count either. And it was a pretty small little needlefish as well. But I did end up catching three very small bluefish. I caught the first one that you saw on the footage on the pencil popper, and then due to operator error with the camera, it was not running when I caught the other two. And then at the end, I tried some tog fishing, but it was just way too rough out where I was. Now, one point that's worth noting in my observation is that as I was walking in, I saw two other people catch tog, little ones, not keepers, maybe 12 inch, 13, 14 inch range. But they were way in closer to the light, further up the inlet, and at a spot where the wind wasn't blowing right into the face of the jetty and pushing that water into the face of the jetty and, you know, causing those waves to smash the rocks and shower me as I was out there fishing right in the face. So they were further inside. I think the water was a little calmer. I think they could probably feel the bites from the fish better. The fish may not have wanted to be in that really turbulent water that I was fishing in either. My thought was maybe they would want to be there because maybe that kind of wave action would knock crabs off the rocks and things like that and put them where those fish could feed, but there didn't seem to be any of that going on. And so these guys were catching fish further inside. And, you know, it's also kind of an interesting Jekyll Hyde situation in terms of weather from when I showed up and had a little bit of a light breeze. It was brisk, but it was fine. To when I left, when a cold front had come through, which I knew was coming through, forecast to, and actually thought that might mean the fish would be really active, but by the time that cold front was coming through, or right after it came through, those winds were just howling. So I thought that was a little bit interesting as well. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed it. Sorry for the long outro, but I wanted to put some things in context. Hopefully, next time we're out, we'll do a little bit better in terms of putting fish in the boat. But until next time, as always, I'm the Brandywine Angler Manly Parks. Thanks for watching. We'll catch you next time.